Today we're going to be talking about how to live frugally on one income. My stay-at-home moms and dads, you don't want to miss this. This will include how to save money on your utilities, on clothing, and any items you need to purchase. Stay tuned. Welcome to Healthy, Wealthy, Skinny, where we focus on the steps to help you live a healthy, wealthy, and skinny life. I'm Sean, and let's get into our topic for today. Living on one income, and more specifically, living frugally on one income. When we think about families that live on one income, we instantly think about our stay-at-home moms and dads who made the awesome decision to stay home and take care of those precious gifts, our kids. There are many situations where you might find yourself in a one-income family, and this might be loss of a job, accident or illness, taking care of an elderly parent, or you or your significant other might go back to school, so one person is in school while the other person works. These are all options and situations where you would be in a one-income family. So let's talk about how you can live frugally with that one income. Tip number one is to live by a budget. And if you've been on this channel for a while, you know I always talk about having a budget. Without a budget, you don't know how much money you have and you don't know how much money you're spending. So tip number one is to create a budget, and this needs to be a budget that you can stick to and live by, and live by that budget. If you don't already have a budget, I want you to check out the video above me or check out the description. I leave a link to a video where we talk about how to create a 50-30-20 budget, and we also give you a free budget spreadsheet that you can download. And that video tells you all about how to create your budget by using the spreadsheet and how to maintain your budget throughout the year. That is something you definitely want to do, take advantage of, and download your free copy if you don't already have a budget. My next tip is for you to check prices before you buy anything. It's really easy to go to a store, see an item, and just buy it. Or be online shopping on a website, see an item that you want to get, and instantly buy it at that point. But how do you know you're getting a good deal? You need to comparison shop. Check other websites. Use apps. Me personally, I always check Amazon to see if I can get an item for a lower price. And 9 times out of 10, I can. I also have a few browser extensions. I use the Chrome browser, and there are some great extensions that will comparison shop for you. And I'll leave a link to some of those in the description. But my point is, make sure you check prices. Even if you're grocery shopping, check different stores. If you're shopping for clothes, check different stores. You want a comparison shop to make sure you're spending wisely and you're getting the best deal for your money. My next tip is to shop off season. And this is one that I learned from my mom. My mom will always shop for things way in advance. So in the summer, she's buying winter clothes, and in the winter, she's buying summer clothes. She is always ahead of the game. 9 times out of 10, by October, she's already done with Christmas shopping. So if you shop off season, you can find some awesome deals. Now, here's a tip with shopping off season. If you go into your favorite store, look for the clearance section. That's where you're gonna see all of the off-season clothes and things that are heavily discounted. And this goes for clothes, shoes. So in your favorite stores, just make sure you look for that clearance section and see what kind of deals you can get. If you are a trendy shopper and looking for the latest styles and fashions, then this tip may not help you. But if you're thrifty and like to look for a good deal, then shopping off-season is the way to go. My next tip is to skip new and buy used. That's right, buy used items, and I mean everything. You can find really cool used clothes at thrift stores. You can find used shoes online at Poshmark, and I don't mean anything. You can find some good used shoes and things like that if you just look around on Letgo and Poshmark. Those are two of my favorite places for shoes. But also, you can find used equipment and furniture. I can't tell you how many pieces of furniture that we have found just by looking on the Facebook Marketplace or the Letgo app. We've got some really cute bar stools that match perfectly in our man cave downstairs. We found a really nice desk that I needed for my VA. Just a lot of stuff that you can get just by looking online. And I mean, I'm not talking about bad stuff. I mean, really good items. We also found a really nice table for my entryway on Facebook Marketplace as well. So you can find some really good used furniture online. And I'm pretty sure the same goes for equipment such as video games for your kids. If you have younger kids, they don't need the latest and greatest video game. You can go a couple of versions back, find them a used version, and you can probably also get the games as well at a huge discount, and that's gonna be great. They're gonna love just playing with a game. So this tip is skip new and buy used. My next tip is another one of my favorites. I have a whole video about it, but this one is to shop using apps. 9 times out of 10, you have a smartphone, so let's put it to some good use. Let's get cash back on our purchases. You have to buy gas, so why not get cash back when you're buying gas? You have to buy clothes for your kids and for yourself. There are things around your house that you have to buy. Why not get cash back when you're doing those things? I use 3 main cashback apps, and that is Dosh, Ibotta, and Ebates, and they're very easy to use. If you'd like to know more about that, I'll leave a link in the description or right above me where I give you a review of my 3 favorite cashback apps, and I tell you step by step how to use them. It's a pretty long video, but you can skip around and find the portion of the video that talks about the app that you're interested in, and you can also tell your friends about the apps and make a little extra money on the side. There are also apps, like I referenced earlier, that will help you comparison shop. You can use those as well. Getting a good deal or buying something for the right price also saves you money. So use the technology that you have right in your hand that you carry around with you every day, and use that to live frugally on that one income. My next tip is to eat at home. And this will save you tons of money. And trust me, I know, because I am notorious for eating out. So for me, when it came time to save some extra money, eating out is one of the first areas where I knew I need to cut back. And you save tons of money eating at home because you can buy your groceries in bulk, you can meal plan, and let's just face it, you eat healthier meals at home. You're cooking them yourself, you know exactly what's going into them, so eating at home is just best for you all the way around. My next tip falls right in line with eating at home, and it is to do planned grocery shopping. And I do mean planned grocery shopping. And by planned, I mean shopping on a schedule. Going to the grocery store once a week. This is planned grocery shopping. Not going to the grocery store every day and picking up a meal every day and possibly random items that you don't need to spend on. You're gonna plan your grocery trips. When you go to the grocery store, you're gonna shop with a list, meaning you're only gonna buy those things that you need, and you're gonna meal plan. If you meal plan, then that means you know exactly what you're cooking for the entire week. You can buy only those items, and you can make sure you're picking frugal foods and making frugal meals, and that way you're gonna save money on your grocery budget as a whole. So again, in this tip, do planned grocery shopping. Plan the whole experience from what you eat, what you buy, and when you go grocery shopping. My next tip is to manage your utilities. And utilities is an area where households usually waste a lot of money. And what do I mean by manage your utilities? This means turn off lights that are not in use. If it's during the day, don't use overhead lighting. Use sunlight. If you have a window you can use, open up the curtains and make use of that natural light. Now let's move on to how you're using your washer and your dryer. Don't wash every day. Make sure you gather up your clothes and do a full load. When you're washing your clothes, wash on cold instead of hot. That's going to reduce your utilities. You can reduce the amount of times that you use your dryer. If there are things that you can lie and dry or hang up in your laundry room, do that, and that is going to reduce your electric bill. Another thing that you can do to reduce your utilities is to unplug items that are not in use. And I actually tried this, and it works. So let's say you have items such as TVs or lamps in areas that are not in use. Instead of just turning them off at night, unplug them. You'd be surprised the difference in your electrical bill. So if you really want to be frugal, unplug things at night. Only plug them in when you're using them, and you're gonna see that utility bill drop. If you haven't already done so, be sure to like this video and subscribe to this channel. And make sure you hit that bell icon so you know immediately when I drop my next video. For a complete list of things that you can do to live frugally, go ahead and check out this video right here. It has 50 frugal tips to help you thrive this year. And then after you watch that video, you might want to check out the video right here because it's a video that YouTube has chosen just for you. I'll see you next week, but go ahead and check out this video. Bye.